liberal viewer present.
So the Israeli-Palestinian conflict is very complicated, but you rarely see those complexities addressed in the American media, and even more rarely by American elected officials, as pointed out last week in, of all places, The Daily Show with Jon Stewart on Comedy Central, using the great montage you can see in this clip.
Hamas's continued insistence on firing rockets into Israel, and Israel's continued insistence on the soul-crushing segmentation and blockading of Gaza, is a very complex situation. Obviously, both sides of the complex situation are vigorously championed by American politicians.
I understand Israel's desire to protect itself.
I think what the Israelis are doing is very important.
Israel has no choice but to take military action.
The Israelis are doing the only thing they can possibly do to defend their population.
The missile firings into Israel, I think, brought a proper response from the Israelis.
See? It's the Mobius strip of issues. There's only one side.
Now, the reason U.S. politicians have such a simple, one-sided view of the current Gaza conflict has a lot to do with the popularity of Israel versus the popularity of Hamas, as NBC's David Gregory explained to Jon Stewart later in that same Daily Show episode in response to this question.
Why can't any American politician criticize Israel in any way for their behavior? I'm watching these shows, and there's not one person going, geez, it's kind of complex. Yeah, Hamas is a bad actor. They shouldn't be throwing missiles. But,
right.
Gosh, you know, the treatment of the Palestinian people maybe for the past 50 years, not so nice either. But you never hear that.
No, I think that's a fair point. I don't think that...
It seems like it's a more complicated situation
right.
than is portrayed.
Well, but it's complicated in terms of the whole situation remains complicated.
Right.
In this particular instance, there's very little love for Hamas. Not in America, not in Arab capitals. Abu Mazen, who leads Fatah on the West Bank, has criticized Hamas. There isn't a lot of admiration for Hamas's tactics or even their strategic vision throughout the Middle East and certainly in America.
Now, David Gregory's explanation that American politicians choose to support an Israeli democracy that's more popular with their constituents than Hamas makes some sense, but it doesn't explain the journalistic bias towards Israel nowhere more evident than at, you guessed it, Fox News, as you can see, for example, comparing the interview question and follow-up with an Israeli government official I'll show in a moment, with Fox News reporter Greg Jarrett's question and follow-up with Palestinian legal advisor Diana Bhutto, from last month, you can see here.
The Israeli military launched its attack on Gaza because Hamas simply would not stop firing rockets into Israel. Would you agree that Hamas is to blame for all of these terrible Palestinian deaths?
Absolutely not. You are blaming the victim. It has been proven time and again that even when Hamas does not fire a single rocket, and it's important to note that these rockets do not have explosive heads, that nonetheless, Israel continues to fire upon Gaza. Over the course of the past 2 years, there have been close to 2,000 Palestinians in Gaza who have been killed. And most recently, when Americans were celebrating the election victory of Barack Obama, Israel used that opportunity to go into the Gaza Strip and kill Palestinians. So this is not at all a question of Israel simply responding. It's a question of Israel initiating. And this is a violation of international law.
Boy, you are completely misrepresenting the facts, but I'll move on.
Now, both that interview question and follow-up were pretty harsh, though the harshness itself wouldn't disqualify it as journalism if Greg Jarrett had challenged Diana Bhutto on specifics, rather than just labeling her statements as misrepresentations. But compare that harsh questioning of the Palestinian advisor with the softball question and follow-up you can see in Greg Jarrett's interview with Israeli cabinet minister Isaac Herzog this week here.
Hamas militants, terrorists, have fired more than 6,000 rockets raining down on innocent Israeli civilians. Now, those are war crimes under the definitions of the Geneva Conventions and the Hague Convention, and yet the United Nations never mentions that. Instead, their latest salvo is to accuse you in Israel of grave human rights violations. What's your reaction to the UN?
Are you talking about the UN Committee on Human Rights in Geneva? That was already a totally unobjective discussion and an unobjective vote. Throughout, it was clear to us that there will be an automatic majority which doesn't want to listen. For example, Why would they listen? Why would they listen to the fact that hundreds of thousands of Israelis were in jeopardy in recent months and years? Why would they listen to the fact that we've given ample warning? Why would they listen to the fact that we agreed to a ceasefire? We absorbed missile launchings into Israel. We agreed to extend the ceasefire and Hamas said no. And lastly, why would they listen to the fact that we're combating a terrible guerrilla organization which hijacks children and women, which uses people's homes as their launching pad for missiles? And this is the real question that faces the international community.
Yeah, you're right. It's the Human Rights Council.
Huh. So what do you think? Even if you agree with Fox News reporter Greg Jarrett's assessment of the events in Gaza, did his questions and follow-ups in those two interviews cross the line from reporting to editorializing? And on the bigger bias question raised in the exchange between David Gregory and Jon Stewart, does the one-sided treatment of the conflict by American politicians and media result from Israel's greater popularity? Or does Israel's greater popularity result from the one-sided treatment of the conflict by American politicians and media?
YouTube, you decide.